Guys, what is going on out there today? Brent Abel here, webtennis.com. Thanks for either joining me live or for watching the replay of this YouTube live video at the Web Tennis channel. And man, my glasses look like they've got something on. Hold on for 1 second. I want to talk about a couple things today. Number one is I want to talk about the Rafa Fed match. And if you're recording it and don't want to know the result, then shut down from this thing right now. And the other thing I want to talk about today is also, you know, when, and I guess it's primarily, well, it's not really primarily singles because it does apply to both singles and doubles. But what do you do when you get that short ball sitter? And so we'll talk about those two things today. The first thing is on the Fed Rafa match. And again, if you're recording it and just tuning in, don't want to know the score, hang up, get out of here. This is, I'm going to let you know. But the one thing that really impressed me today with Roger was winning the first set in the breaker and then just absolutely kind of getting thumped in the second set, 6-1. And it just didn't seem to really make a difference, right? It didn't make a difference in his mind. I mean, he's kind of going, all right, what's the worst case here? Worst cases were it, you know, one set apiece. And so to him, I don't think he really looks at the score of 6-1 and kind of goes, uh-oh, I'm in trouble. I think it's more just like, all right, that just happened. Let's just kind of put it in the past. We're done with it. Let's not dwell on it. And again, you know, worst cases were one set all. That's fine. So I think that happens a lot in our matches is we either play a couple of games where maybe we've been up, you know, we're up a break and we lose the break and we start to kind of hit the panic button a little bit. And you got to make sure that you don't do that, right? You got to make sure that you just stay the course. And I thought Fed was a great example of that today, winning the third and fourth set, 6-3, 6-4. The other thing I want to talk about is with that short ball sitter. And let's start with singles. I mean, and this is actually, this was the topic today over at Gold Ball Hunting's podcast, which you can find the video version at YouTube. We've got a channel over there, Gold Ball Hunting. And then also you can find us on iTunes and Stitcher, the audio version. But, you know, when you get the short ball, I think way too often what we think about doing is, I need to end the point, right? The ball's sitting there. Let's say it's 2 feet behind the tee. And the next thing you know is the ball sitting there. And your mindset is, well, man, you know what? You got to take care of this. You got to end the point. And what we end up doing is we don't think of this as a two-shot play. And the reason you've got to think of it as a two-shot play is you can't stop your opponent from anticipating or guessing where you're about to play that shot, where you're about to, you know, play either a big forehand or backhand or whatever you're going to do. And you can't stop them from guessing to which corner, or even if you're going right up the middle as to where you're going to play it. So it's got to be a two shot play. And too often what happens is we think of it as one shot and we just unload from that part of the court and we just stand there. There's no footwork, right? So two lousy things potentially can happen is you try to unload from there. It looks like good geometry, but it ends up not being all that great. And you end up either burying the ball in net, you go deep, maybe go wide. But because there's no footwork, you kind of lose control of the swing. So the other thing, too, is if you do hit a good shot and the opponent guesses that that's where you were going to hit it, now you're still stuck behind the service line. You know what? That's not a great spot to be after that shot. So think of it as a two-shot play. It's an approach shot. Absolutely. You can go heavy with the shot because you do have good geometry, but you got to make sure that you got good footwork as you go through that so that you get better control of the swing, number one. But the other thing, too, if the guy does guess, the gal guesses where you're about to play that shot, that you now are in a better geometric court position to challenge them to have to pass you. So guys, would love to read your feedback on those two things, kind of the Fed mindset after that second set today, and then also on that short ball sitter. And we just mentioned singles, but the same thing applies in doubles, right, with that short ball. Lots of times you get a short ball and you go for the big dinger outright winner from somewhere behind the service line, and you either miss it or else they anticipate where you're going, and now you're kind of hung out to dry. because you're still stuck in that court position. I got a couple things for you. Number one, top spin serve, right? If you're throwing in too many double faults or your second serve is just a little cream puff, doesn't have much spin, or it comes up short, it's landing short and just sitting there giving the returner the advantage, I want to help you out. I've got a free course. It's private, meaning that you've got to sign up for it. Just got to jump on my email list over at webtennis.com. Just go on over there, drop in a first name and email address, click the button, and you'll get access to a course that is titled How to Crack the Top Spin Serve Code. There's three things you got to be able to do. Any skill level player can do them, but you got to make sure that all three of those things are happening for you to be able to really create that nice, confident, high bouncing, let's even call it a kicker type of serve that eliminates double faults, but also does not give the returner the advantage. And the other thing I've got for you is over at Gold Ball Hunting is we have got two things. Number one, a private video. It's free, but it's going to help you reduce your skill level range, right? That one day when you go out, you play to the max of your current skill level. You think you got the game nailed. The next day you go out and it's not up here. It is down here. And so really what we want to help you do is reduce your skill level range where you're always playing. You're bringing the bottom of that skill level range always up to the top. So when you go out there to play, whether it's singles or doubles, you're confident that you know how you're going to play on that day. So the way to get access to that private video, again, it's free. Just go over to goldballhunting.com. Again, drop in a first name and email address, and you'll get access to that course. Guys, with that said, get out there today, wherever you are. I'm here in Northern California. Beautiful day, beautiful afternoon here. Moraga, California, a little bit east of San Francisco and Berkeley. But wherever you are, get out there, help someone else have a spectacular day. And let's do this again tomorrow.